We bless the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. We welcome you from home. We just say the Lord again has been good. The Lord has been gracious. This morning the Bible says in Psalms 37 verse 4 that seek your happiness in the Lord and He will give you every single desire of your hearts. Even as you worship this morning, may you worship from a point of victory. May you worship from a point knowing that the Lord is for you and not against you. Hallelujah. 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 We bless your name, Jesus. We bless your name, Holy Spirit. Be lifted in our hearts, we pray. Hallelujah, Jehovah, be lifted, we pray. We bless your name, Moya Oingwele. You alone are God. You alone are the Restorer. You alone are Jehovah. You alone are El Shaddai. You alone are Ebenezer. We bless your name, mighty Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Uyawubuyisa umphefumlo wam. Uyawubuyisa umphefumlo wam. Uyawubuyisa umphefumlo wam.
Home perfume. I bless your name. I give you all. I give you praise. You are the life, the truth, the way. I bless your name. Bless your name. I bless your name. I bless your name. I give you all. I give you praise. You are. Bless your name. I bless your name. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Oh.
closer than a friend.
Uno, uno tando, Baba. Uno tando, ena yedwa. Uno, uno tando. Uno tando.
Thank you, Lord. We bless your name, Jesus. Hallelujah. We bless your name, O Lord. Hallelujah. We bless your name, O Jesus.
Well, greetings, church, in the wonderful name of Jesus Christ. Amen. We greet our pastors, Mom Jay and Pastor Jay. Greetings to the families that are watching us at home. We are glad that you could join us once more for our online service. The word of the Lord, it says that when they said to me, let us go to the house of the Lord, my heart leaped for joy. Amen, Bazalwane. So this is the day that the Lord has made for us to rejoice and be glad in. May you please join me as we open the service in a word of prayer. Amen. Father, we thank you, Lord. We give you the glory for this day that you have made. We give you the honor, Holy Spirit. We say, come and take control of us, O God. So they come, Lord God, and captivate each heart, mighty God. Lord, we give this time to you, O Father, as families. Capture the hearts of the old, Lord God. Capture the hearts of the young, as we are about to hear your word, mighty God, voices that might seek to speak at this time, mighty God, we are declaring that this time is yours, mighty God. Our hearts, Gosiama, surrendered unto you, Heavenly Father, and we say, Lord, do as you please with us, mighty God, this day, in the name of Jesus, have your way, and we say, let your name be lifted up. Let your name be exalted, mighty God. We thank you so much, Heavenly Father, for what you are about to do. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen, and amen. Well, please take note of the following announcements. On Wednesday, we have our normal prayer and intercession at 6 p.m. And then on Thursday, we meet again as cells in our various areas via Zoom, also at 6 p.m. And now for the ladies, it is still Ladies Month, so please be on the lookout for more sessions to follow. We will update you on our social media pages, so be on the lookout on our Facebook, YouTube, and so on. So at this moment, please help me welcome our mother, Pastor Shubi. Thank you.
Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, church. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah is the highest praise in this morning. Amen.
Amen.
Isn't God good? Isn't he amazing? Isn't he great? Isn't he awesome? Oh my goodness.
Praise God.
He's a great God.
We thank him this morning. We thank him even today.
For keeping us. For saving us. Father, this morning, we acknowledge your precious name. Come on, let's stand and pray together. Father, we thank you. We honor you this morning, Daddy. You are amazing, you are amazing, you are amazing, you are amazing, mighty God. High and lifted up, the whole earth filled with your goodness. Engasoza aphinde abekhona sibiza wena ke maqhoba yakhawuleza sibiza wena ke sonini nanini sibiza wena ke somandla umanga kekho kanti ukhona
kulensa sathixo wethu siyakubuka sikhuqa sikhothama phambi kwetrone yobabalo sibiza wena thixo wethu ngobubele bakho sibiza uthando lwakho thixo namandla enkosi bawo enkosi bawo enkosi bawo high and lifted up the whole earth filled with your goodness. Oh, Jesus, this is the day that you have made. Yes, we will rejoice and be glad in it. We dedicate this time into your mighty hands, O God. And this day belongs to you, my Father. You created it, Lord Jesus. The Bible says before, all the days of our lives, you know them. Before one of them comes to being, O God. And this day, Nkosiyam, we lay our lives down. We lay our spirit down, Lord Jesus. And everything that is within us will bless your precious name, O God. In the name of our wonderful Savior, Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Come on, Amen. Let's give Jesus a big hand Lord clap. Jesus. I know we can do better. Yes, I know we can do better. I know we can do better. I know we can do better. We may be masked, but yes. Hallelujah. Praise Hallelujah.
God. Amen.
Hallelujah. This morning I feel like ululating.
Oh, Jesus.
Because of the victory that our Lord, that our God, that the Holy Spirit has brought amongst us. Yes.
Praise
He promised
God.
Us in His word that victory is certain. Oh, siyanqoba ngegama lakhe.
We conquer in His blood. We conquer in His power. Even in this morning, we have conquered. Praise God.
Oh, yes, Lord Jesus. Jesus, mighty God.
Amen.
Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Uthixo uvusa ibandla.
God is waking up His church.
Eliza kumdumisa.
That is going to praise Him.
Eliza kumzukisa.
That is going to worship Him.
Eliza kumbonga.
That is going to honor Him. A church.
Eliza umagathu.
That is going to
stand aside. Lingabi nanhloni ngaye.
And not be ashamed.
Ibandla.
A church.
Elinamandla.
That is going to be powerful.
Ibandla.
A church.
Elizele umlilo.
That is full of fire.
Ibandla.
A church.
Eliphethe iqhele.
That has got the sword.
Ibandla.
A church.
Elinhlandlombini.
That is to Ibandla. That is carrying the weight.
Ibandla.
A church.
Jesus.
Praise God.
Ibandla elinamandla.
A powerful church.
Ibandla elidiscerning.
A church that descends.
Ibandla elivukileyo.
A church that is awake.
Ibandla.
A church.
Elinxiba umkhaka wezulu.
That wears the crown of heaven.
Ibandla.
A church.
Eline glory.
That has got glory.
Oh, Jesus.
Praise God.
Ibandla.
A church.
Elinenkazimulo.
That has got God.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Oh, Jesus.
Uyehla umlilo.
The fire is coming down.
Uyavutha umlilo.
The fire is burning.
Ophuma etroneni. Uyavutha umlilo.
The fire is burning.
Ophuma enyangweni.
That has come from the heavens.
Uyavutha umlilo.
The fire is burning.
Uyavutha umlilo.
The fire is burning.
Ujikeleza.
It is hovering.
Ujikeleza.
It has engulfed.
Ihlabathi.
The whole world.
Uyavutha umlilo.
It is burning.
Ujikeleza.
It has engulfed.
Ihlabathi.
The whole world.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Uyachisa.
It is Uyachisa.
Hot.
It is very hot.
Uchisa izifo.
It burns.
Uchisa ukugula.
It burns. It burns death.
Umlilo.
The fire.
Umlilo.
The fire.
Ophuma enyangweni.
From above.
Bontali yabasha.
Praise God.
Oh, greetings, church, this morning.
Ulisibandla
ngalenzeni.
There is no way of sitting down. Now we are getting late. We cannot sit. It is getting late. But the bed has not been yet.
It's not yet been folded.
I got song. It is getting late. The church of God. The church of Christ. There
is no time.
There
is no time.
There
is no moment.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Allow me this morning, church, to greet you in the name of Jesus.
Don't sit down.
If,
even if
something good morning, church.
Take this opportunity
again
to greet the whole congregation and respect the elders, to honor the elders, the pastors, the priests, the evangelists, the intercessors. Praise God.
Oh, teachers of the word, we greet you this morning in the entire world, in the province, in the nation, in this city, Port Elizabeth.
Empire.
And I want to prophesy over you, Port Elizabeth, and say,
you are not too young.
Now, Port Elizabeth.
Even you, Port Elizabeth, you are not too young. In the name of Jesus.
Oh, Jesus.
Praise God. We are going to go forward. Because we've got a little time.
Elizabeth.
P.E.
You are arising.
Port
Elizabeth.
Ipai.
The sun
Onyan.
Is coming out of you.
Ilanga.
From the east. Port Elizabeth. You shall arise. Port Elizabeth.
Ipai.
You shall arise. Yes, Port Elizabeth. You will arise. Nothing will be stolen from you.
Yes, P.E.
You will multiply. You will be fruitful. The sons of the soil, the daughters of the soil, will arise and take forth that which belongs to them. But Elizabeth, the divine design of God, the divine design of God will not be stolen from you.
We rebuke the locust upon you.
You will prosper. You will not be destroyed. We silence every lie. We silence every lie from the pit of hell concerning you. The ships of Tarshish. The ships of Tarshish. They are coming.
Zieza.
Carrying gold.
Zipeti golide.
Carrying silver.
Zipeti silivere.
Carrying iron ore.
Zipeti insimbi.
Carrying copper.
Zipeti sinyithi.
To deliver.
Uba zizise.
In your shores.
Ukwinqamelo lwenu.
No lies.
Akusekho ubuxobo.
No drugs.
Akukho
ziziyobisi. No evil.
Akukho bubi.
Will come through your shores.
Obuya kuza kunqamelo lwenu.
All the pays. In the name of Jesus, South Africa, you will arise. South Africa, you are arising.
Africa,
you are arising. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Can we go to the word this morning? The Lord has been traveling with us through prophetic words. We know it is the women's month. But strangely, the Lord is dealing with us in another way. He brought men in these prophetic words. And so, as women, we say this morning, as you lead us, we will follow Lord. And we say to our men, to our uncles, our grandfathers, to our brothers, and our sons, as you lead us, we will follow. Because
you've got what is of God.
You are anointed of God. You are powerful. You are strong. You are amazing. You are a great species. God created you before us.
Because
he knew
that he was going to multiply his wisdom. He was going to multiply his wisdom. He was going to multiply his leadership in you, over you, through you, with you.
Nani.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Can we give Jesus a big hand of praise this morning? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let's go to the word. The Lord has given me a word again this morning. And he pointed us to Jeremiah chapter 1. We are reading from verses 17 to 19. The Lord says, but you dress yourself for work. Arise and say to them, everything that I command you, do not be dismayed by them, lest I dismay you before them. And I, behold, I will make you this day a fortified city, an iron pillar, and bronze walls against the whole land, against the kings of Judah, its officials, its priests, and the people of the land. Verse 19, they will fight against you, but they shall not prevail against you. For I am with you, declares the Lord, to Amen. Deliver you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Father, this is your word.
Oh, yes, Jesus.
Your word is true. Your word is living and active, sharper than any double-edged sword. Let this morning, Lord, your word work through us in the name of Jesus and bring forth fruit that will heal this nation. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Come on, church. Can we give him another big hand
for
his word?
Praise God.
2 days ago, we were in Bizana. I slept, and the Lord showed me in a vision, in a dream, or rather a vision, in a dream. I will not go into the entire detail, but I'll just highlight the core message. In this dream, as I saw a state of hopelessness and a gross situation of sinful activity, where in one street, men were engaging in gross sinful activity, and on another, youth and a few adult men and women were in a rioting state. They were looting, and they were destroying. They were hitting shop with chairs. They were breaking through the walls, or rather the doors. And they were taking groceries, television sets, and anything they could put their hand on. I stood there. The first street was the one for looting. The policemen were all over the place. And there was fire and smoke. And they tried to control the mob, but to no avail. I kind of stood in the middle of all this. I was very concerned and moved with compassion. And I was still wondering, how could the church do, or what can the church do to help the police to stop the chaos? The Lord took me through to the next street, where there were men. It was like a hill bro of some kind. And it was like this street is solely dedicated to these men, I promise you, in this dream, on this street, all forms and kinds of men, men of all ages, were engaging in gross sinful activities. There were parties and orgies. I stood in the middle of this and I wondered, what can we do? How can the church help? But with concern. But I had so much compassion. My heart was grieved. But interestingly enough, I had so much peace down in my soul. And something in my heart said, it is possible. It is possible for all this to change. It is possible for all this to transform. It is possible for all these men to change into what God wants them to be. It is possible that in this world there could be peace. It is possible for the chaos to come to a halt. It is possible through God. It is possible that in the new normal we can be free of all bondage. We can be free of all forms of debt. We can be free of all emotional entanglements. We can be free of all pain. We can be free. We can be delivered from all these. The poverty, the loneliness, the anger, the disappointments, the betrayals that we experience every day. It is possible to be free of hunger. Yes. It is possible to be free from panic. From anxiety. It is possible to be free of depression. And from depression, something said in me. In fact, the Lord was kind of saying to me, this is the state our world is in. The chaos, the rebellion, and all that I saw in the dream, the Lord said, it is as a result of sin and rebellion against His word. The chaos that you see, the Lord said, is stemming out of idol worship and forsaking my altars. And the Lord said to me, it was so. And so it was during the time of Noah. And so it was during the time of Joel. And so it was during the time of Jeremiah. And so it will be. And so it is during your time. And so now, open your mouth just like Jeremiah and tell my people to come back to me. Tell my people to cleanse their hearts. Tell my people to cleanse their ways. The Lord said to me, I appointed Jeremiah. And I appointed him young. I appointed him. I appointed him next to Josiah, King Josiah, that took over after an evil king. That took over after a wicked king, King Manasseh. And so I raised Jeremiah young as my prophet to stand next to kings and show the way. I appointed Jeremiah next to kings and priests to stand and preach my words. To stand and proclaim my prophetic word. The Lord said to me, I appointed Jeremiah young. I touched her lips. I touched his lips. And I touched his tongue. I appointed him to demolish the high places. I appointed him next to a reformer king to break down the groves, the Ashtoreth pillars, the Canaanite pillars, the Canaanite gods, the Canaanite images, the Canaanite idols, the Asherah poles, that my people Israel, that my people Judah, that my people Jerusalem, were worshipping. And so today, just like Jeremiah, I am appointing you my church. I am appointing you my child. I have set you over nations and kingdoms. In the book of Jeremiah chapter 1, verses 9 to 10, the Lord is saying, I have set you this day, Jeremiah, over nations and kingdoms, to do what? To pull down, first to uproot, to pluck up, to break down, to overthrow. After all this, Jeremiah, the Lord is saying to us this morning, after destroying, after plugging up, after pulling down, after destroying, after overthrowing, now Jeremiah, now my church, it is time to build, it is time to prepare, it is time to plant. Very interesting. From verse 11 to 12, the word comes again to Jeremiah. And the Lord visits Jeremiah as he's still visiting you today in visions and in dreams. Remember Joel chapter 2. He says, our old men will dream dreams. Our young men will see visions. Our daughters will prophesy. We want to say to you this morning, daughter of the Most High God, begin to prophesy as Jeremiah did. Sons of the Most High God, just like the sons of Issachar, who knew what time it was, begin to discern, daughters of Africa,
Africa,
daughters of South Africa, daughters of the province, daughters of this city, daughters of the Eastern Cape, begin to prophesy, for the Spirit of God is moving all over the world. The Spirit is moving.
moving
all over the world.
The
Lord is pouring out His Spirit all over the world. There is a mighty revelation of the glory of the Lord as the waters cover the seas. Daughter of the Most High God, in this month of August, this month of August is dedicated to you. Heavens agree and are pouring out His Spirit as He did in Jeremiah's time, as He did in Joel's time, as He did in Noah's time. Systems of living waters are coming underneath to wet the ground, so that when you begin to prophesy, when it is time to plant, when it is time to build,
you cannot get to the hard soil.
You don't come to a desert. When you come to plant, because God is releasing wealth, the Lord is transferring wealth from the world to the church to provide for the project, to provide for them, for His mission, to provide for the end time harvest, to provide during the end time persecution. The Lord takes
Jeremiah
in a place, to a place in a vision, and he asks, God asks him a question that he asked
Ezekiel.
Then the Lord said to me, verse 11 says, and the word of the Lord came to me saying,
Jeremiah,
what do you see? Then the Lord said to me, before the Lord speaks, and I said, Jeremiah answered, I see an almond branch. I see an almond branch. In Israel, when they name almond, the almond tree, they say it's a tree of hasty, a tree of quickening, because it is the first tree that appears in spring. As you would know, that spring is a sign of the beginning of the new things. They speak of the new normal. We are not scared of the new normal. We are not shocked of the new normal, because His mercies are new every day. We live in His freshness. We live in the beauty of the newness of His grace every day. And the Lord said to me, I am quickening my word. I am quickening my things to your favor. I am quickening you. I am placing you in your lane, in your favor, for your favor and for your future. Be strong, church. The state of the world may be chaotic, but the Lord has a word for you. Seek Him. What is He saying to you this morning? He is saying to us this morning, after you have destroyed, after you have overcome the pandemic, after you have burned it with the fire from my throne, I am giving you a seed. I am giving you a seed to plant. I am giving you an almond seed. You will get a harvest that will shock the nations. What do you see?
What do you see? What is your calling? What is your burden? What has God given you? The eyes of the Lord are still searching to and fro for the Jeremiahs that will dare to take up the challenge, that will dare answer God, that will dare say, I am ready, that will dare say, I am here, Lord, send me. The eyes of the Lord are looking for Jeremiahs that will dare say, I am ready to uproot. I may be weak. I may be immature. I may be inexperienced in the things of God. But here I am, Lord. Send me to break down, to destroy, to overthrow, to build, and to plant. In the portion of scripture that we read, God is calling on his church. He says, but you, gird your loins. Hey! Gird your loins. It is amplified.
That is what the amplified says.
It is gird your loins.
It is ubhinqeni ube mfutshane.
What does the Bible say?
It is in the Bible.
When it says, gird your loins.
I say to ubhinqeni ube mfutshane.
God is saying to us,
uthi,
stand up.
Masime.
Arise.
Masiphakame.
Prepare yourself.
Masizilungiselele.
Position yourself.
Masizimise ngomume.
In the midst of opposition.
Esizikithini sokhaso.
The Lord is saying to us,
undikhoyo uthi ke kuthi,
when he says get your loins,
I said to ubhinqeni ube mfutshane,
prepare for change.
I said ilungiselelana utshintsho.
Prepare for a shift.
Lungiselelana uguquko.
Be ready.
Zilungiseleleni
for battle.
Ukubonga kwimfazwe.
Be ready.
Zilungiseleleni
for hard work.
Ukusebenza nzima.
The Lord is saying,
undikhoyo uthi,
when he says get up,
I said iphakamani.
We are going up.
Stand
up, my church.
And
arise. He is saying to us,
there is a way. There are things ahead.
Tribulations and trials may be coming your way. Get ready. Get ready. Get ready. Take up your swords. When the Lord is saying, get up your loins. He says, put on the armor of God so you may be able to stand against the wiles of the evil one, the arrows of the evil one. When they come to you, they will ricochet.
Because they will find you because you have been encouraged.
What is the Lord saying to us? When he says, get up your loins. He says, prepare for war. Prepare for war. This war we are talking about is not blood. This war we are talking about is not a physical fight. For we wage not against flesh and blood, but we wage war against the rulers, against the principalities, against the authorities of the dark world in high places.
Josiah
and Jeremiah were appointed by God to go into the heavenlies, to go into the second heaven, to pull down strongholds of promiscuity, to pull down strongholds of drunkenness,
to pull down strongholds of drug abuse and drug addiction, to pull down strongholds,
praise God,
of theft, to break down walls of corruption. Jeremiah was appointed by God to get up, to stand up, to arise and be counted. The Lord says, the waters will come, the fire will come, the winds will come, the storms will come, but as they destroy, but as they help you destroy, all these will elevate you. Do not be afraid. Do not be dismayed. I am with you. And I am your God. But you, Jeremiah, get up your loins. Put on the full armor. The breastplate of righteousness, the belt of truth, the helmet of salvation, the sandals of the gospel, the sword, which is the word of God, the shield of faith.
Also,
you're
going to use
your shield and your shelter. When the arrows of the enemy come, it will come. They will come from seven directions, from one direction, and go back, Deuteronomy says, in seven different directions. We speak disunity in the camp of the enemy. They will go and speak ill of the church, united, but the Lord will come and the Lord will raise intercessors. The Lord will raise prayer warriors with full armor to sabotage the plan of the evil one. Jeremiah says, no plan of God will be thwarted. Church of God, Church of Jesus Christ, the Lord is saying, I will make you. Number one. And I, behold, I make you this day a fortified city. What does God mean when he says, you will be a fortified city? A fortified city is a well-fenced city. A fortified city is a safeguarded city. A fortified home is a home that cannot be penetrated. A fortified life is a barricaded life. A fortified family is a cemented family. A fortified work and a fortified church is a reinforced church. You are a tight city. You are enclosed. Yes. It may look like we are surrounded, the song says. But you are surrounded by him. The host of heaven are hovering around your place right now. The host of heaven are hovering around your home. The host of heaven are hovering around your life to protect you and guide you with the shadow of his wings. But there is a warning. There is an action. But
There is an encouragement that goes with this promise. The Lord says to Jeremiah, do not be afraid. Keep nothing from them. Spare nothing from them. Tell my people. Spare no kings. Spare no priests. Tell them everything that I've told you. Tell them that there is an army that is coming from Babylon, that is coming to destroy Judah. Church of Jesus Christ, there is an army on
YouTube.
There is an army on Instagram. There is an army on Facebook. There is an army on WhatsApp. Those cries, those bodies that have come to derail my children from their way and from their will, from my will, declares the Lord. There is an army that I can as God, and I may release to come and destroy and work havoc. But because you are anointed, but because you are appointed before me today, but because you are consecrated, you are appointed a prophet, I trust you, my church, to speak forth my words in this chaos situation. I trust you, my church, to speak forth my words in this promised your situation. He says in verse 12, then the Lord said to me, you have seen well, for I am watching over my word to perform it. The Lord is saying, I am watching over my word to perform it. I am watching over my word to fulfill it.
My word
is
going to make things come forth. It is hovering.
It's over the peoples. My word is waiting for your declaration. My word is waiting for your prayers. Number two. Before we go to number two, God is saying, spare no kings and spare no priests. He says, tell the kings that the borrowed monies of Corona are not for cars. The borrowed monies of Corona are not for parties. The borrowed monies of Corona are not for houses. He says to the priests, pastors, evangelists, teachers of the word, prophets, not the false prophets, but my true prophets, the monies for tithes are not for the boot. The monies for tithes are to establish my kingdom. Destroy. Do you remember in the book of Samuel, chapter 15, when the Lord asked prophet Samuel to go and reprimand, to go and correct King Saul, because King Saul had not destroyed the Amalekites completely. He took some of the fattened calves and animals and kept them. The Lord showed him and said, go and reprimand. It is time for the truth. Speak the word. Do not be afraid of them. Because if you are afraid, afraid my church, I will come against you. I will be afraid of you. I will give my back to you. Do not be afraid. Number two, God says, I will make you. In fact, I am making you this day an iron pillar. What does God mean when he says, you are an iron pillar? My church, my daughter, my son, you are unbreakable. You are unbendable. You are unbreakable. The trials, the tests,
is lingo.
The tribulation.
In koleko.
The tribulations you've been through.
In koleko kritekuzo.
They have only made you stronger.
Zikwenze womelela.
Because I have been with you.
Ngoba bendinawe.
Before the foundations of the world.
Ngokwesekho zehlabathi.
I made you immovable.
Ndakwekha wangashukunyiswa.
When the Lord says,
undikhoyo uthi,
I have made you this day.
Ndikwenza namhlanje.
An iron pillar.
Insika yensini.
He says,
he means,
you are unbeatable. You are unbreakable. You are immovable. You are strong. Come out. You are strong. You are coming out of that situation. Better and not bitter. You are coming out. Fire. Fire that will burn the chaff. Fire that will destroy idol worship and sin. Fire that will overcome and will make you overcome the enemy. The Lord is saying, trials and tribulations, fires and storms, may come near you. They will come and try to attack you, but they will not come near your tent. You will not fear any terror of the night, nor the stock or the stocks in Tonga
and the arrows
that fly by day. Speak my word.
Jeremiah.
What do you see? Jeremiah saw an almond tree. The Lord is saying, number three, I will make you, and I've made you this day like bronze walls. Like bronze walls. Yeah. Against the nation. Against the whole land. God is saying to us, church, the territorial spirits, the betrayals, the territorial spirits of idol worship,
and also the,
will not destroy you. The territorial spirits of witchcraft will not harm you. The calamity that the enemy has released from in the periphery, from the second heaven, will not harm you, because you are a fortified city. You are an iron pillar, and you are a bronze wall. I have made you this day, and I've given you authority over kings, over nations, over cities. You are taking over, church, the answers that the world is looking for is
going
to come out of you. You will stand the test of time. The Bible says in the book of 2 Corinthians, chapter 4, verse 8, we are knocked down, but we are not destroyed. Yes, we are pressed hard. We are pressed dashed on every side. But will not be crushed. What is God saying to us? God is simply saying, I am making you invincible. Church of Jesus Christ, you are invincible. My daughter, my son, you are invincible. You are too powerful. This is what invincible means. Invincible means you are too powerful to be defeated. You are a warrior. You are an overcomer. Child of God, gird your loins. Child of God, be set apart. Child of God, arise. There is no time. There is no time for earthly positions. There is no time to seek earthly positions. There is no time to look for relevance. There is no time to impress the world. There is no time to be under pressure to perform. There is no time to act. There is no time. The time now is over. It is time for impact. It is time for influence. It is time to stand strong. I'm about to give you a strong race. And the long race, I'm giving you strength to run a last lap of the last days. My church, I'm giving you wisdom to gather. I'm giving you seeds to gather the last harvest. I'm giving you space to occupy and to preserve, to collect and to preserve the last harvest. Do not be afraid of them. Do not run away. Onesimus, come back. The word and the name Onesimus means you are useful. Onesimus means you are profitable.
This word.
Onesimus, the man. Onesimus was a young man who worked for Philemon. Philemon is an apostle that worked closely with Paul. The Bible says Philemon was a wealthy apostle. And I want to prophesy right now and say, church,
prophet,
seek his face.
Apostles,
do his word. Because he is ready to transfer the last transfer of wealth. The
last transfer of wealth
to his church.
Philemon
worked for God.
Philemon
was an apostle.
Philemon
preached the word.
Philemon
was a wealthy man.
Philemon
was a holy man. But the word says he prospered. And so
Onesimus
had stolen from his master. Had stolen from
Philemon.
His boss. And ran away. To
Rome.
Running away. From his sin. God is saying this morning, Onesimus. Come back.
Onesimus.
There is a place for you.
Onesimus.
I have invested wisdom in you. I have invested purity in you. I have invested righteousness in you. I have invested my glory in you.
Onesimus.
Do not run away.
Even though you have sinned.
Come back home.
Do not forget. Come back home. Do not forget.
But
in your home, there is a weight. Do not forget. That you are wealthy at home. Do not forget. That God is with you. Do not forget. That where God has
blessed
you.
Come back to God. Because in you, there is an anointing. Because in you, there is a word of God. Because in you, there are souls. In your belly, there is a last harvest.
Onesimus.
Come back. In the Church of Jesus Christ, in the past decade, we have seen children of God leaving their homes, leaving their spiritual homes for places where they'll be taught a nice gospel. Where they'll only be taught what they want to hear. In the last decade, we have seen children of God, those sons and daughters. This is across the spectrum. This goes across the Church of Jesus Christ. In the whole world, we have seen worship leaders. We have seen elders. We have seen prophets. We have seen intercessors that are anointed to be in a certain home, leaving their homes because they were scolded. In the past decade, we have seen
mystery.
We have seen a mystery where an anointed child of God cannot say no. If you say no to them, they run next door. They go to the church of an uncle where they'll be allowed, as if it is the pastor who is demanding this. Yet the pastor is just a vessel.
He's just a vessel. God says,
preach my word
unashamedly.
Preach my word uncompromisingly. Preach my word fearlessly. Preach my word boldly. I am your God. I have made you today a fortified city. I have made you today a bronze wall. I have made you today like a threshing sledge. Where? When they come to you, truth will be separated from the lies. Onesimus met up with God in Rome through Paul. But at the end, when they came together, he ministered and followed after his name. He was useful to Paul. Because Paul was in prison. You are a fortified wall. You are a bronze wall. You are a pillar in the house of the Lord. Do not leave. Do not leave Onesimus. He was a fugitive.
Why?
And he was running away as a slave.
and a servant.
But
after their reunion
with
Paul,
no Paulos,
they came back
Babuya
to Philemon.
Philemon.
He came back now
Wabuya
as a brother in Christ.
No
longer
as
a slave.
Come
back. Come back.
Buya.
Come back, Onesimus.
Buya, Onesimus.
Fortified.
Paganyisiwe.
We are fortified.
Paganyisiwe.
To do what?
Ukuba senzeni.
As we prepare to land.
Asilungisele ukuhlala.
We are fortified.
Silungise ukuphakanyiswa.
We are fortified.
Siphakanyisiwe.
Somelezelwe.
We are fortified.
Siluqilima.
We are stronger.
Silukhotheko.
We are reinforced.
Siyintsimbi.
We are a strong pillar.
Ukuze kuthini?
So for what?
We are fortified.
Somelezelwe.
To preach the gospel.
Ushumayela ivangeli.
The gospel of salvation.
Ivangeli yentsindiso.
We are fortified.
Somelezelwe.
To preach the gospel.
Ushumayela ivangeli.
Of reconciliation.
Yoxolelwaniso.
We are fortified.
Somelezelwe.
To preach the gospel.
Ushumayela ivangeli.
Of forgiveness of sins.
Yoxolelo lozono.
We are fortified.
Somelezelwe.
To preach the gospel.
Ushumayela ivangeli.
Of restoring.
Yobuyiselwa
relationships.
Kwekobudlelwane.
We are fortified.
Sobuyisomelezelwe.
To preach the word.
Ukushumayela ilizwi.
Of God.
LikaThixo.
We are fortified.
Somelezelwe.
To preach the gospel.
Ukushumayela ilizwi.
Of love.
Lothando.
We are fortified.
Somelezelwe.
To preach the gospel.
Ukushumayela ivangeli.
Of peace.
Yoxolo.
We are fortified.
Somelezelwe.
To preach the gospel.
Ushumayela ivangeli.
Of joy.
Yolonwabo.
We are fortified.
Somelezelwe.
To raise the banner.
Ukuphakamisa.
Of salvation and deliverance.
Intetho zosindiso nokhululwa.
We are fortified.
Somelezelwe.
To proclaim.
Ukuvakalisa.
His inerrant word.
Ilizwi lakhe elingapheliyo.
Uncompromisingly.
Singenzeleleli.
There is no time. There is no time. We are fortified. What time is it? We are fortified. To seek God's face. To follow his instructions. To obey his words. To turn away from our wicked ways. To repent. For the kingdom of God is at hand. It's time to get up our loins. It's time to prepare for a fight. It's time to rise up. It's time to arise. It's time for prayer and intercession. It's time to destroy Babylon. It's time for the world system. The enslaving world system. The controlling world system. To calm down. Fugani.
Wake up.
Fugani bandla.
Wake up therefore, church.
Fugani.
Wake up.
Fugani bandla.
Rise, church.
The Lord is saying.
Undikhoyo uthi.
You are like that tree.
Ninjengalowo mthi.
That is planted by the streams of water, and whatever it does prospers. The Lord is saying, just like that river that came out from the east and watered the Dead Sea, he's saying to us, you are fortified. You are a pillar to heal nations. Your leaves are for healing. And your fruits is for food. My church, you are strong and you are fortified to heal the nations. Father, this is your word.
Oh, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Daddy. You are amazing. You are amazing, mighty God. We bless your name this morning. We bless your word this morning.
Let this word go through the nations. Let this word, like a river that is flowing, take on a mantle and your spirit overflowing over the nations. It is healing, oh Father. It is delivering right now in the name of Jesus. Our fathers and sons are coming out of promiscuity. Our fathers and sons are coming out of jails. Our fathers and sons are getting their loins. They are approaching your throne in multitudes and multitudes. We thank you, Father, for your word is true. Let it do its work, Daddy, in the name of Jesus. We bless your name, Father. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah, church.
Praise God.
Can we give him a big hand? Can we give Jesus a big hand of praise? He is amazing. He is great. He is awesome. Well, may the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. Shine his face upon you. Give you all your heart's desires. And make all your plans succeed. We bless him. Oh, hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen and amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
Glory.
Hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Siyambulela kakhulu uThixo ngelo lizwi. Siyakubulela kakhulu mother. Siyakubulela kakhulu ngendlela uThixo akusebenzisa ngayo. Greetings, bazalwane, ngegama lenkosi uYesu. This is an awesome time. This is really a blessing to be here, even right now. Ndiceliwe ukuba ndize ndizokwamkela umnikelo. I'm really grateful to umfundisi Pastor Jay, ndiyabulela kakhulu na kumother Mama Magadi, ndifuna ubulisa I congregation at large. Siyabulela kakhulu even to those that are connecting and the friends of RAC PE. We are grateful that you have connected today. We know that you were blessed and your life will never ever ever be the same again. Right now, without wasting any time, let us just go straight to encouraging the congregation with giving. This has really changed my life. My name is Siyanda Macingwane. Ndisindisiwe. Izono zam zixolelwe. I really want to emphasize on this. And even in this Women's Month, I really want to emphasize that uYesu useyinkosi. Hence, we are still going on giving. We have so much to be grateful for because today we are alive. We have so much to also be thanking God for because he has kept us through it all. He has been faithful to us and he has exceeded our expectations so far. We have heard umfundisi sharing the greatest news that we have been waiting for, the approval of the plans and the rezoning, and also we're about to purchase this building for the Lord. Amen. Can we quickly turn to Genesis chapter 12? Genesis chapter 12. This is a story about Abraham, but I just want to give a background where in Genesis chapter 11, we see people trying to build their own way of doing things and which was not pleasing to God. If I could give a background, we see that there was a nation that was trying to build the Tower of Babylon. This nation was coming and it was full of us because they were trying to preserve themselves. They camped in a valley and then they came up with a solution that they must build a tower. So they said, let us build a tower. They said, let us make it to be so tall so that even if we might be scattered, we might have a place that we can come to. And let's build this tower to be so high that we can get to go and knock in the heaven's doors. So this system was built on us. But on Genesis chapter 12, that's where we are going to be looking at today. I would like us to look at this system, God's system. Genesis chapter 12, verse 1 to 3. The Lord said to Abram, "Go out from your land, your relatives, and your father's house to the land that I will show you. I will make you into a great nation. I will bless you. I will make your name great, and you will be a blessing. I will curse anyone who treats you with contempt, and all the people of the earth will be blessed through you." Amen. Amen. If we look at Genesis chapter 12, verse 1 and verse 3, this is God's system. This is not about a person. It's not exalting any man. It's not exalting any woman. But in this scripture, we find that God is saying, come to a land that I will show you. So, in our lives, we need a divine revelation. We are being taken to a land that we do not know. We have been hit by COVID. That is a land that we didn't know. But God was taking us to the land that He is going to show us. He is taking us again to a land that He is still going to show us. So He is still going to reveal mysteries in our lives. We also see Abram being called to divine expansion. Divine expansion. That is where we are, even as RAC Christian Church PE. Remember, we had accommodations where we were before, but God has called us into this land of plenty, the divine expansion. And look at the time where God is expanding us, at a time where it is not supposed to be, but because God has called us to say, I will make your name great. Even right now, we are at that time where God is about to launch us as RAC Christian Church PE to make the name of the Lord great. And again, if we look at Genesis, again, God is saying, I will bless you. So we are entering into a space of divine empowerment. God is about to empower us divinely because He is calling us into a space that we cannot stand on our own, into a space that we cannot do it for ourselves and with our own strength. But God is saying He will bless us. And again, God is calling Abram to a space of divine protection. Let us declare it today that what God is about to do needs protection. Hence, it is God Himself that is saying, I will fight with those that fight with you. God is promising us that as He is taking us forward, He will fight those who are fighting us. He will fight the poverty. He will fight the diseases. He will fight anything that seeks to stand in the way of what God is about to do. But today, I want us to also remember that God, as He is building His own system that is different from what the people were trying to do, their own system, God is calling us to be a blessing. That means we are being called to being a divine channel. A divine channel. God is looking for those that will tithe in the house of the Lord. God is looking for those that will give even beyond what they think they could, because God is looking for those that he will bless every nation through. Ladies and gentlemen, even right now, as we partner with RAC Christian Church PE, even in the buying of the building, even in giving our tithes, even in giving our offering, we are saying, Lord, use me. Lord, here I am to be the divine channel of your blessing, because God is clear to say, I will bless those who bless you. God is looking for tithers. God is looking for divine partnership. So those that will stand and that will say, we will give everything that we have. We will give even more than what we are expected to give. If you are here and if you are at home, right now, as you are about to give to the Lord, God is looking for hearts that are saying, here I am, Lord, use me. Here I am, Lord, use me. With everything that you have blessed me with, here I am, Lord, use me. This is the appointed place for all of us as Rakas. Hence, God has promised us that he will bless us as he is blessing us. It's because we have to sow in the work of the Lord. This is our place of worship. Therefore, don't move because of famine. Don't move. Don't be disconnected. Stay passionate. Stay giving. Stay doing what God has called us for. Even in this time of famine, the famine will be over. The economy is now shifting. In the west of time, the economy is shifting. The spiritual economy is shifting. Here we are, Lord. We are saying, use me, here I am. Use me, here I am. Let us bow our heads and close our eyes. Lord Jesus, we know that Isaac reaped 100-fold because he stayed. Even whilst Abraham moved to Egypt, but Isaac stayed in the promised land because you had promised that you will show them the land. You will expand them. You will bless them. You will make the other nations to be blessed through them. Even right now, as RAC PE, we are saying, here we are, Lord. We are submitting to your will and we are submitting to your ways. In Jesus' name, amen.